Well, John and Dome, who else to represent an exotic animal than the lawyers at Jungle Law? You see their billboards like the one behind me all over town. The two lawyers who make up this group now have a brand new client.
Lost in a legal jungle? Have no fear. The lawman is here.
It's an unforgettable marketing campaign, and it's working.
I feel like anytime there is an animal, an exotic animal in Kansas City, it makes sense to call Jungle Law. So people tend to reach out to us.
Two of the firm's newest clients are Catfish the alligator and his owner, Sean Casey.
It was my pet.
I knew right away he was, you know, he was passionate about this animal. He grew him up from, you know, 12 inches to almost 7.5 feet now, 200 pounds. He's very well kept. He said he kept him better than he does himself. By the looks of the alligator, I think that's the truth.
Casey Animal Control took Catfish November 7th after Casey was evicted from his home. They also seized three pythons and a rabbit. It is illegal to own an exotic animal in Kansas City.
Catfish is a remarkable alligator because, as you know from personal experience, he's pretty friendly. We just want to make sure that everything that's required in his lifestyle will be available to him.
He told me about how unique it was that he built this, basically a pool in there in his living room. And he would fill it with water, and Catfish was just hanging out like me and you are sitting there talking right now. He'd have an alligator just sitting right here with us. He used to take Catfish through the McDonald's drive-thru by him, and everybody knew who he was. He'd sit right next to him. This is the drive-thru. I mean, it's...
The chicken nugget eating alligator is now at Monkey Island Rescue, but his future is up in the air. People from as far away as Florida have called to offer Catfish a home.
It would be great for Catfish to stay with his owner because his owner is, you know, a wonderful caretaker. But at the end of the day, we're just looking for a place where Catfish doesn't have to move around. He can be permanently there and hopefully get a lot of Wendy's chicken McNuggets in the meantime.
So even though the Catfish story is funny in many ways, Woods and Sierra are serious lawyers. They practice all sorts of different kinds of criminal law and malpractice and things like that. They don't make any money on the animal cases. They say they do it because they're animal lovers. They've been on rescue missions across the globe. They have actually drafted legislation that would make animal abuse a felony. It is now a misdemeanor that will start working its way through Jefferson City sometime in December. If you'd like to support this bill, you can log on to animalabuselaw.com and sign the petition. We'll have more coming up on Fox 4 News at 6 about what you can do to protect yourself in this case, and if you want to own an exotic animal, what you need to do. Shannon O'Brien, Fox 4 News.